And now you're ready. Right, this is Tony Paddy here at John Paul, right? I must explain to you our video yesterday. We never made no videos. You did, right? Now, first of all, you want to fight James. And if James didn't accept your fight, you said to challenge my brother Dave, right? James was in the back ward just that day. He wasn't going to fight you. Ready to come back. Then you said, no, I don't want to fight James. I want to fight Dave. Hoping that Dave, right? Hoping that Dave wouldn't take the challenge.
Would refuse you.
He did. He accepted it. Right, that's grand.
Now, but he's knocking, with your bald mouth, he's knocking you out.
Right, first start, right there. I'm three brothers, I'm myself. I'm the worst of the three brothers, John Paul, right? Now, fair enough, you didn't mention my name yet.
I proved that you're the worst of yours.
Right, you did mention Jimmy's vice, right? Fair enough, but let's get back to your brother Paddy, right? Michael, he said he'd fight Mike. You said that he will fight Mike. Michael said, right, he'll accept it in 12 weeks' time. Now, he's at a young neighbor.
I'll fight him in the year.
Michael Navin. Michael Navin rang up there yesterday.
John Paul, right. That man there left you with brain damage.
One second.
Michael Navin rang you up and asked you, Paddy, Michael will be ready in 12 weeks. Down. You turned around and you said, I'm not fighting Michael. No way am I fighting that man. Now, Michael Navin can verify that, right? And Levi, right? That's fair enough. Now, just go for one more minute. You're saying, John Paul, that you ran the McDonald's old fingers. Hold on. Look who you're talking about. Mine was Kathleen, a woman with two girls and a little young boy going down breaking windows along to a woman and a husband in jail, right? Then you're talking about Uncle Nick and his woman. No one in the house with the Uncle Nick and the woman. Now, when the boys came up from all over Ireland, you ran into your little fort in Villa Park and you're
in the rat hole that you won't come out of. You're afraid of your life for coming out of the
Now, what I want to say...
When you're talking about putting people, you're talking about, say, running people, right? I'm running you since 0-0, that's right. 12 years ago, right?
Right?
Who ran to England? I was supposed to fight you, Paddy. Cowdy, right. Paddy. Cowdy shit.
Right.
You're Paddy shite now.
When you won,
now, man, one second. I challenged you for 8 weeks to fight you on the 1st of April, which was the first Sunday of April, it was April Fool's Day. But there was no fooling out of me on April Fool's Day, because you went in 3 weeks before the fight, and you stayed over there for 3 months, you dirty, cowardly
right,
bastard.
Right.
You cowardly fuck that won't fight me, only afraid to fight me.
If you,
only say, one second, you said that you have another man there waiting for me in the 12 weeks. Well, any man, Paddy, any man that you think is able for me, because you're not able for me, you're refused me now a rake of times, your brother, you're on the YouTube, you're saying you want to fight me, I'm begging to fight you. I said I'd fight you, and I was talking to Ditchy Patrick when you, Paddy, was boxing D-Boy in Mullingar. When you said what you said, to tell Jimmy Prince Michael that I'm the man that did it to his place. What I'm telling you now, Paddy, cowardly arse Paddy, that ran and left his children in the house. I'm telling you now, you know I got my own back, and the country knows, the whole country knows that I got my own back on you. So will you fight me, Paddy, at the same time the boys fight me?
Right.
And stop being a cowardly bastard like you are. The breeders are, you're acting like the breeders you are, a cowardly people.
Right.
And I tell you another thing. Any man belonging to you, put him out that day and I'll bail him. I swear to three children's life, I swear to Danny's mum's life, that I'll knock him out the same way I did it to you with your bald mouth.
Right, Jimmy.
With your bald mouth, you know I do it.
Right, let me explain.
You know I do it.
You won't accept Michael or Cowboys Michael, because at the end of the day,
you must have forgot about the bait that I gave you when you asked me that you wanted to fight me again.
You're not as stupid as people look, right? I can't blame you not fighting Cowboys Michael or Michael. I can't blame you because, see, those boys are in the Premiership, you know. You're in the 4th Division, they're right, boys.
That would be it.
That's it.
You're a different league.
You never get out of
it. You're a different league.
You're in the 4th Division.
You're a different league.
You're a different league.
Now, you're a different league,
and maybe you might challenge me, Paddy. Or I might accept your challenge, Mr. Paddy, right? Because if you do, right? Or your brothers, it's not for me. I find don't need every strength, right? I do what I've done to Edward McDonough over in Baycamp. When I was drinking with Holland, James's Chewy, Richie McCann and Juki all night, up all night, went to bed, never went to bed, tried to get me in the hop, come out next morning, and I put his ears drums.
Everybody knows about the guard.
Chewy, my nephew Chewy, 17, closed Jason's eyes and everyone's looking at
the morning
back, back
the
right?
morning that he was standing at a wedding, he was doing he was doing best man's
wedding. I'm only saying right before we go, right? He wore his glasses, right? He was going around like Ray Orbison, right? Singing Lonely the Lonely. And Kitty turned around. How did you let Chewy, James Chewy, 17-year-old, beat you, Jason? Now, we'll go back to man. I'm the ass man. He's a lot of shy hardy. He was the worst of the whole of them, right? And then you call out Jason. I call him Shane. He's an old...
Simple boy. But anyway, we'll leave them anyway.
They're rubbish.
Forget about it. We'll get back
on Boris
Mouth and the Collinses, the ones in the Villa Park.
That's my...
If there's ever a man that will fight me, now Paddy refused me to fight. Me brother Dave is fighting Boris Mouth, John Paul, and Bacon as well.
What?
And he's going to beat you, John Paul, the same way that I beat you. Right? Me nephew, me nephew Huey is fighting Bimby's fella that had nothing to do with it, but Bimby's fella, John Paul, is getting in, oh my God, oh, you're running Garchap. You're getting it, right? Me nephew Huey's boxing you. Fat face Jamie, you're good for nothing, clear more cook buttery body. Me nephew Ginger's gonna punch the face here. Now, Paddy, this is you, Mrs. Paddy. If you are brave enough, I would fight you in the 8 weeks. But since your little men put it back for 12 weeks, I swear my mother's life that I'd be there waiting for you, Paddy. And I will be there, and I will bait you, Paddy. And if you're not there, Paddy, if there's a man of your name, of a Collins, if there's a man of the name of a Collins to send him out to me, Paddy, that I swear me three children's life, that I knock him out the same way I did it to your brother John Paul with the Boris Mouth, the exact same way. And to see you, Wavy Davy, when my nephew Ginny gets a hold of you, that I swear me child's life, he's going to slap you into the face.
I swear me mother's life, and
I'm not finished with you, dirty either.
This is Collins and Paul. It's going to be now, right? Today, tomorrow, next week, 6 weeks, I invite you to 2 weeks together, one by one up the road, any time, any money you want. I'm here for you. Cody,
you have no money, you don't, and you don't have to get money. Don't me, that's all you are, don't me.
Don't fight me.
You're government acts. That's all you are, you're government acts.
If I find on the door,
you dirty little man, I'm so unfixing. Come out, fight for 12 weeks, fight for fucking 12 weeks. I've had fucking been about fight for 12 weeks, and we'll keep the dirt going as well, because nobody's stopping with the dirt.
You're that cold.
Nobody's stopping with the dirt.
You're that kind, never stop with you breeding people.
Yeah.
I see you, Titan. See you, you dying, small, peely, homeless face. And Kevin Collins. See you, I made you send your van and send it to so you wouldn't go up the market. Do you remember what I did to you, Kevin Collins? I dragged you to the bed and I cut you with a samurai sword, Kevin Collins. And nothing that you or your son did do anything about it. I read somebody's own going to ride a sword. I beat me left, right and centre. I stabbed Buns Paddy 8 or 9 times in the face. I shot at John, I shot at Anthony. Only for that man here, saved you Buns Anthony, you proper smurfs bastard, you.
Right.
12 years ago, I put a gun in each your leg and he saved you. He fucking saved you. I spent my child's life. I'd be out now. Spent my child's life. You're not bloody dog.